Hi everyone, Tony from Hack the Movies here, and I hated the ending of Eli. Eli is a movie that's currently on Netflix. It was recently added, I believe. My girlfriend decided she wanted to watch it, and I felt bad that I had to make her watch Jack Frost recently, so I was like, okay, let's watch Eli. I was in the mood for a ghost movie. You guys know I've done The Shining recently. I saw Dr. Sleep. I was just in a ghost mood. You know, I'm still high on Halloween. Want more ghost stuff. So she turns it on, and I'm invested. The movie's about a kid named Eli. He's a bubble boy. What's a bubble boy?
He lives in a bubble.
Boy.
His family takes him to this weird mansion run by doctors who have like some kind of experimental procedure to cure him of his condition. And while he's there, he starts to see ghosts of presumably other patients. And he also meets a little girl who lives somewhere around the mansion, and she's the redheaded girl from Stranger Things. And yeah, it's a fun ghost movie for two acts. I was invested. I cared about the kid and his family. They're all good actors. I wanted to know what was wrong with him. I wanted to see him get cured. I was curious about the ghost. Where did they come from? Why are they going after him? Why are they sending him messages? I was real invested. And it sets up a good mystery. Why are there ghosts? Why are they doing all this stuff? And the movie, I thought, was giving me clues. And then the ending happened. All right, so here's the spoiler part. If for some reason you clicked on this video, even though I clearly put that it's about the ending in the title, one, you're stupid. Two, click off now, because I'm gonna talk about the ending of the movie. I'm gonna talk about it right now. Right now, are you still watching? I hope you saw the movie, or I hope you don't care, because I'm gonna talk about the end of the movie. So it gets to the third act. Eli has done some investigating. He's noticed that all the previous patients are dead and they are the ones haunting him. And it turns out that the entire ending is the omen getting an exorcism. That's right, Eli didn't have some weird allergy condition. He's the son of the devil. And his parents sent him there so nun doctors, secret nun doctors, can perform demon gene therapy on him to get rid of his devil. And then it doesn't work, so they have to kill him with a sacrificial dagger. Sound familiar? Sound familiar? Sound familiar? Killing son of the devil with daggers? Sound familiar? It sounds familiar for some reason. So they try to do that, and then Eli's skin changes colors, his eyes change colors, and stuff starts floating around the room while they are trying to get the demon stuff out of him. Sound familiar? Sound familiar? Sound familiar? Does it sound familiar? Yeah, it all sounded familiar. This is the laziest ending I've ever seen. I could not believe it. The movie really hooked me in with the ghost stuff. The ghost scares are really good in this movie. I was genuinely creeped out by some of the ghost effects. And oh my God, I just stood there appalled. The writers, I assume, had no idea how to end this movie. I feel like they wrote themselves into a corner, because I just hit Suburban Commando. Sorry, Hulk Hogan. I was really curious where the movie was going. I had no idea where it was going. I don't think they did either. Look, I know it's really hard to write movies. I know it's hard to come up with endings. I know it's hard to write horror movies. I wrote a bad horror movie. It's called Top Floor. It's on my original channel, and it's terrible. Don't watch it. The difference is, that was a film made by just, you know, a college kid who drinks too much trying to imitate things he liked in movies and went to YouTube and was seen by maybe five people. You got a Netflix movie. Your movie made it onto Netflix. You should have tried a little bit harder. More people are gonna see it than my horrible short film. So they just pulled like a cheap, he's the son of the devil, and they do an exorcism and everyone flies and goes on fire and there's fire everywhere. Oh, and the little redheaded girl is his demon sister. So it's kind of like Devil's Advocate, where you find out Keanu Reeves has a demon sister. So yeah, the ending is just stuff you've seen before. I was angry. I wasted like an hour and 30 something minutes. It's horrible. I can't believe it. I've seen bad movies. I've watched some bad movies recently, but I haven't seen a movie in a while that made me angry. This movie really made me angry that it tricked me into caring and then just blindsided me with the most cliche thing possible. So that's it. If you saw Eli and you hated it, I hope this video gives you, you know, I hope you're happy that someone else feels the same way as you. If you liked the Eli ending, please leave a comment, because what is wrong with you? And if you didn't see Eli and you were curious how it ended and you watched this video and you weren't mad that I spoiled it, give me a thank you. Just shoot me a thank you. And yeah, that was my, I couldn't even do a full proper review. The movie's just bad. There's my review. Well, not even review. There's my rant. Make sure to like, share, subscribe. I have a Patreon, shirt store, Twitch. I've been streaming a lot more on Twitch, so do all that fun stuff. And yeah, don't watch Eli. Demand a refund. I know it's on Netflix and it's streaming on there and it's a Netflix original. And there's no way. Just send a letter to Netflix. Wait, hey, can you deduct a dollar from my bill this month? Because I watched Eli and I hated it. Go do that. Have fun. Bye.